Hello everyone, welcome to the Planet Earth channel, and today we're diving into the fascinating world of termites. Most people have heard that termites are tiny ants that can cause massive damage to wooden structures, capable of reducing a house to ruins in record time. Once termites get involved, restoration is usually out of the question, but the reality is even broader. Termites don't just destroy wooden buildings, they can wreak havoc on many things humans have created. Luckily for us, only a few brave species dare approach our homes. Most termites prefer to build their elaborate mounds far away from human settlements. All right, that's a decent start. But there's so much more to know. Termites are full of surprises. Let's get into it. Termites appeared on our planet millions of years ago. Their ancient ancestors were much larger than today's species, but over time, evolution did its work, molding them into what we see now. Originally, the first termites lived in trees. However, as the climate warmed and forests receded, they had to adapt, learning to build gigantic mounds. In places like Australia and Africa, termite mounds can reach an astonishing 10 meters, about 33 feet in height. Considering the average termite is only about 3 millimeters long, these insects are, proportionally, the most ambitious builders on Earth. If scaled up to human size, their structures would tower several kilometers into the sky. Termite mounds deserve to stand among nature's greatest adaptations, much like the human brain itself. And intriguingly, the evolutionary mechanisms behind them might be very similar. The diversity of termites is staggering. Today, there are nearly 3,000 known species. They vary in size, color, lifestyle, and a multitude of other traits. Termites are among the most widespread insects on the planet. If you weighed all the termites alive today, their total biomass would rival that of all the world's vertebrates. You quantitista possesti, humans included. In South Africa's national parks, you can find over a million termite mounds bustling with life, making it one of the most densely insect-populated regions on Earth. The largest termite mound ever recorded was about 13 meters tall, over 42 feet. Today, termites inhabit almost every continent. The only exception is Antarctica. In Russia, only two species of termites have been found. Their body size typically ranges from 2 to 5 millimeters, depending on the species and the individual's role in the colony. That's right. Termites live in massive colonies with a strict class structure. Colonies can number between 2 and 3 million individuals. Each insect has its own duties. Workers, arguably the most unfortunate caste, are completely blind. Their eyes are either absent or so underdeveloped that they're useless, but that doesn't hinder them. Their sense of smell is incredibly sharp. Interestingly, biologists have identified the queen's pheromone after years of research. A simple hydrocarbon compound acts as the chemical emblem of absolute authority. Workers and soldiers perceive this scent as the unmistakable signature of their queen. It's not grand halls or armies of courtiers that define termite royalty. It's this invisible chemical crown. Termites spend their lives in utter darkness, underground or hidden inside wood. In such an environment, chemical communication is not just advantageous, it's essential. The queen is the mother of the colony. She can lay tens of thousands of eggs per day. Queens are far larger than the other termites. They continue to grow throughout their lives until they are unable to move on their own. When necessary, workers simply carry the queen to a new location. Soldier termites defend the mound. They have oversized jaws and can't feed themselves. Workers must tend to them. To avoid food shortages, termites cultivate fungi inside their mounds. Their diet mainly consists of plant material like leaves, dung, and decaying wood. Termites themselves are a vital food source for many creatures. Invertebrates attack them relentlessly. That's why soldiers stand guard. Some termite species have a glue gun organ on their heads that shoots sticky liquid to repel attackers. But if an enemy breaches the defenses, it can wipe out the colony completely. Mammals such as anteaters and pangolins also prey on termites, smashing open their mounds and feasting on the insects inside. Termites are their primary source of food, and termites can't survive without their mounds. Exposed on the surface, they perish quickly. Termite mounds grow continuously as long as the colony is alive. However, the visible above-ground part is just the tip of the iceberg. The real stronghold lies hidden underground, sprawling for meters beneath our feet. Termites can work on a single mound for centuries, generations building upon the efforts of their ancestors. Inside, the mounds are riddled with a labyrinth of tunnels, chaotic to us, but perfectly navigable for their builders. Humidity inside a mound remains high, regardless of the outside climate, thanks to the remarkable ability of the mound walls to trap moisture while keeping out rain. But where does the moist air come from? Termites dig subterranean tunnels that channel water vapor into their homes, creating a self-sustaining microclimate. Now a common misconception, termites and ants are often thought to be related because their homes, mounds, and anthills look similar, but that's where the resemblance ends. In reality, termites are close akin to cockroaches. Yes, our familiar house pests. Scientists have confirmed this through extensive research, despite fierce debates. In Mexico, termites have formed a symbiotic relationship with the ant tree. As termites burrow through the soil to reach the tree's wood, they aerate the roots, helping the tree breathe and thrive. Meanwhile, in Australia, termites build thin, slab-like mounds that look like tombstones, strategically oriented to avoid the harsh midday sun and prevent overheating. The size of some abandoned termite mounds is so enormous that large animals like buffalo and even elephants sometimes take shelter inside them. Fun fact, researchers have found that termites can dampen the sound of their footsteps to avoid attracting ants. Despite their blindness, termites can detect the thudding march of ants and react by reinforcing walls with clay and moving quietly, their footsteps becoming 100 times quieter than those of ants. Sometimes they even mimic ant vibrations by drumming with their heads and bodies, a clever alarm system warning the colony of danger. Termites play an essential positive role in the environment. Like ants and earthworms, they drive the global cycle of nutrients within soil ecosystems. They're also a crucial food source for many predators. And let's be honest, without termites, where would the elephants hide in India? And humans? Well, we'll just keep building beautiful, tasty wooden houses for termites to dream about. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. It really helps the channel grow. This was Planet Earth. See you next time.